Hey guys, hope you're having a great day today. My name is Daniel, and I made a previous video covering the Farberware portable dishwasher. And in that video, I talked about the unboxing. We went through the normal cycle. What we did not do is go through the rest of the cycles. So I had somebody reach out and say, hey, can you please make another video covering those cycles? So in this video, we're going to be covering the rest of the cycles on this dishwasher, just kind of giving you some feedback after each one, and then hopefully that can help you be able to make a better informed decision on purchasing your future dishwasher. We'll get right into the video. So real quickly, before we get into the meat and potatoes of actually loading up the dishwasher for each cycle, me showing you all of that, I just want to kind of go through the manual and show you what the wash cycle talks about. You can probably find this in the description on Amazon or on Farberware's actual website. But real quickly, just want to talk about the different cycles. So normal, obviously that's going to be the longest. That's 2 hours and 10 minutes. All of them use a full 1.3 gallons of water. I'm assuming that's the 5 liter mark. It's for to clean normally soiled dishes. And then the rapid, which is the first of the several we're going to be going through today. The rapid cycle is made for shorter washes for a lightly soiled dishes. And it only lasts 40 minutes. So if you have some dishes that, you know, it's not caked with a whole bunch of sauce or a whole bunch of whatever you've got going on your dishes, it's made for that, to where it doesn't take as much. It's not going to have to really clean it very thoroughly. It's almost already clean, but you just don't want to have to scrub it down yourself. So the next one would be baby care. And it says it's suitable for washing baby bottles. Steam is added to it. So that is almost as long as the normal one, the normal cycle. That's exactly 2 hours. So that's the second longest one we have on this list, baby care. And then for fruit, it's the hard wash hard surface fruit by manually adding cold water. So if you're obviously going to be wanting to wash some of your fruit that can withstand water beating down on it, you're going to want to add cold water straight from your faucet. Don't mix it hot and cold water. That's just going to be straight cold water. That is 20 minutes. And obviously, you don't add detergent. That's the only one that you don't use detergent on this cycle. And then for glass, this is for lightly soiled, delicate dishware. And that is the third longest. So that's 110 minutes. So starting from the top, the normal is 130. The baby care is 120, the glass is 110, and then the rapid is 40, and then the fruit is 20. All right, so what we're going to be doing first is the rapid cycle. This rapid cycle is much shorter. It's only 40 minutes because the dishes are going to be soiled a lot less. So if you have a bunch of dishes that just have barely anything on them, you don't need over 2 hours worth of cleaning. It can be knocked out very quickly, just briefly cleaned up on the rapid cycle. Or if you have lots of dishes that are, you know, about the same, there's just not a whole lot. They haven't sat there long. It's fairly easy to just, you know, hit it really quick. The rapid cycle may be your best friend if you're going to be getting this dishwasher. So I've got the reservoir all filled up in the back here. And we're just going to push this in. I'm using the Finish Powerballs detergent. That's just what I've had for a while. So I'll be using that, one of those in there. We'll go ahead and put it in there forward. I got quite a bit of smaller things in there that don't require a whole lot of work. So I'll go ahead and get the Finish Powerball in here and put it in there. And then it'll just fall out down there. But we'll get it all loaded up and then get this on our way to the rapid cycle. All right, so we're going to go ahead and push the power button. We're going to hit the rapid cycle with air refresh. That will do the drying aspect of it as much as it can. And then we'll just go ahead and hit start. And it'll start beginning there. All right, so you can see we've got about 11 more minutes on the rapid cycle with the air refresh on to help dry out the moisture in there. And then we'll be going on to the next cycle. All right, so this rapid cycle is now done. It's the next day, and we'll just kind of look in and see how much water is left over. You can see there's just some water on top of this cup there. There's some water on the outsides around here, the plastic, and some water dripping from here. So you might need to do a quick little dry down on this rapid cycle because it doesn't have the full effect of the normal cycle. So next we're going to go to the baby care cycle. I don't have a child and I don't have baby bottles or anything like that to really clean and show you, but I do have a dog and I have some frisbees and some water dishes that I'm going to clean through that, and I'll just kind of show you the results on that. All right, so it is the next day after the baby care option was used, and the air refresh is in use as well. So let's go ahead and check out the results here. It's a lot cleaner than it was. I don't know if these are water droplets or something before. You can kind of see inside here, there is still just some water on the bottom here. Let's see. It's a lot cleaner. Is that? So this, I believe, is been cut up a little bit by the dog's teeth from before. And I guess a little bit of residue in there left over. But overall, it looks like it's much cleaner. This was caked with slobber and dirt from being thrown around outside. So obviously, you might not have as much issues with baby bottles, baby care stuff. But we'll go on to the next cycle, and that will be for the fruit. All right, so we're going to do the fruit cycle next. This is the container that they give you, and it's pretty sturdy, able to let all the water rinse off of that. Got some apples here, and you can kind of see there's some crummy stuff in the in there by the cores there. So we're just going to run a cycle on this. This is just water. There is no cleaning solution in there. And we will go ahead and get this started. And just before I do this, I just wanted to make sure I show you guys that I'm gonna be putting these two layers down, and that's just getting those things unsnapped from there, putting that down, putting this one down, and then I'm able to lay this inside, put this inside without any of those pointing up, put it in there, and then start it up. All right, so we're going to check the fruit cycle. I just had some apples in here. Obviously, I got fairly cleaned out here. That's looking good. And just a light little washing. I think it's 20 minutes. So this is what it can do for your fruit as you are you know, preparing food or whatever you're doing. Just a light washing. Just make sure it's cold water, and you'll be in business. All right, so for the last cycle, it's going to be glass. This had some macaroni and cheese in it. So this is going to be our really good test to see how well this does. And then I've just got a lid from a pot to be able to go in here and see how it goes. And then we'll show you the results. All right, and here it is. Got the glass setting on, the air refresh turned on, and then we'll go ahead and hit start. Man, would you look at that go. Second ago, that bowl was literally covered in yellow sauce from the mac and cheese, and it is almost clear. So we are looking good on the glass cycle. All right, so we've got the glass cycle done, so we'll just kind of inspect this real quick. The big bowl, that looks pretty clear to me. If you remember, that had a whole bunch of mac and cheese all over it, caked on there. It was pretty hard, and it loosened it up, got it pretty clean. This top to a pan looks like it has some maybe more deeper residue on there. I don't know if that's from the detergent or if that's from just a harder stuff on there, but this doesn't look the best. Maybe I'll try to do it by hand and try to get that cleaned off, but There's that. But yeah, this bowl, that is about as good as it's gonna get, it looks to me. Looks like a little bit left over. It's not perfect, but this looks pretty solid to me. So this is the glass cycle, and this is the last cycle that we're doing. So I'll just kind of give my thoughts as we wrap this up. So hopefully this was a help to you as you're checking out the different cycles for this specific dishwasher from Farberware. I can just tell you my personal experience over the last about 2 months or so that I've owned this. I've really enjoyed it. It's been a lifesaver with, specifically for me, I hate doing silverware and spatulas or all those types of things. Cooking utensils, I hate cleaning those. And this has done a great job for all of those, specifically plates, cups. So for me, I'm okay with doing just the big pots and pans when I have to, when I do cook. And then everything else pretty much just goes in here. And usually it's on the normal cycle or maybe the rapid cycle. Everything else besides maybe the dog toys generally just goes on the normal cycle, and it does a great job. It gets a thorough clean. The actual air refresh, it's not a complete drying system. It sucks just the air out of there to keep the air moving forward, so eventually the moisture would eventually get out. But generally, if I put this on right before I go to bed, and then in the morning when I wake up, generally there's not a whole lot of water left. You kind of saw in the video already that there are some some drops or little pools of water. If I had more glass dishes or glasses, but for me, generally, I'm just going to do the normal, the rapid, and that's going to work fine for me. It probably would for you as well, just getting a thorough cleaning. But anyways, just wanted to cover this, going through the five different cycles. So if this video is a help to you, just consider subscribing, hitting the like button if you got good value. And for me, I want to share what I have in my house, things that I really do believe in, what I've seen online, and then when I buy it and I use it. And I just want to share that with you as I'm just kind of going through this process of filling up my house with different utensils and tools and all sorts of things. So hopefully this has helped you. Hope you have a great day. Stay safe and God bless.